chapter 35 and verse 3. Ye shall kindle no fire.
You shall do what?
You shall kindle no fire throughout your habitations upon the seventh day.
So now, does that mean if I live in Alaska, it's cold in my house? Am I supposed to just freeze to death? So what is that going into? Cooking hot food. Cooking hot food. So God says, guess what? I want you to prepare. He's trying to make us an organized people. I want you to cook everything you need to cook. And by the time it's for you to relax, all you got to do is get up and eat. Or in the next day, which will be today, after we come and keep the Sabbath and teach, make sandwiches, cold food, everything like that. You understand? You might even eat less. Because guess what? He's trying to make us more healthy too. That's why he gives us a day of atonement that everyone has to fast. You understand? God's laws is to help to us spiritually, mentally, and physically.
Bring it out.
Nehemiah 10:31. So you shouldn't be eating hot food on the Sabbath day. Now, I don't know why black people always have to make excuses. Well, what am I going to eat then? You buy cereal all the time. You eat lettuce wraps all the time. You eat sandwiches all the time. And now when God says something, black folk don't know what the hell to eat. Just do what God says, adapt. You adapt when you lose your job. You adapt when that tie goes flat. Adapt to God's laws.
Wait. Nehemiah chapter 10 and verse 31. And if the people of the land bring ware or any victuals on the seventh day to sell, that we would not buy it of them on the Sabbath.
So let's say it was people selling stuff on the street. Or a hotel's open. On the Sabbath day, you gotta buy to get in there. You know, 9 times out of 10 is black folk in there. But if God's people did this on the Sabbath day, read it from the top again.
And if the people of the land bring ware or any victuals on the seventh day to sell, that we would not buy it of them on the Sabbath.
Do you not understand that the only way that these places still stay standing is because you keep breaking God's laws?
Right.
So, what are we waiting for? When you start to keep God's laws, God's kingdom will build up. The other nation's kingdom, which we're in now, will crumble. So what you doing on the Sabbath? No working. No working. Okay? No cooking hot food. Prepare your food before. And you're not supposed to buy and sell. Okay? Those are things you're not supposed to do on the Sabbath. Now give me Hebrews 10:25. Now, while we are here all together, as a congregation, let's see what it is.
The book of Hebrews, chapter.
Lucas 23, that's what I want. 23 and 2.
I want to ask you a question right
there. I'm finishing the Sabbath day, I got you right after this, okay? And if you got questions, ask questions. I want you to ask questions, okay? All right,
the book of Leviticus, chapter 23 and verse 2. Speak unto the children of Israel.
I just keep hearing the children of Israel, I'm not hearing everybody. That means this book is written to the Israelites, for the Israelites, by the Israelites. So when you see someone else with the Bible trying to tell you what to do, that ain't your people, you should not be deceived.
Right.
Don't be deceived.
Speak unto the children of Israel, and say unto them concerning the feast of the Lord, which ye shall proclaim to be holy convocation.
Holy what?
Holy convocation.
God made the Sabbath day holy, which makes it a convocation. Meaning you're supposed to be congregating. You're supposed to be around like believers. That way, guess what? If you're around like believers, let's say me and you know to keep the Sabbath. But we decide to be around a cookout on Saturday. It says the wickedness of the wicked is going to seduce us. We're around cooked food. We shouldn't be around that. But if we're around like believers that know that the stove's supposed to be off, we all keeping each other back to keep God's commandments.
That's
the importance of not being an individual. We came here on boats together, we're going to have to leave together. We came here and changed black men and black women, chained together. We got to leave together. Read what you got.
Speak unto the children of Israel and say unto them concerning the feast of the Lord, which ye shall proclaim to be holy convocations. Even these are my feasts.
So when you read the book of Leviticus chapter 23 on your own time, it goes over all of God's high holy days.
Right.
All right? So you'll know what holidays or holy days God wants you to celebrate. So you can reprogram your mind and get Christmas out, get birthdays out, get 4th of July out, get Juneteenth out, which they just made another holiday to put up more black people to sleep. How you going to tell me to celebrate my freedom, but you ain't let me free?
Right.
What's your question?
No, You had answered already. I was asking, how can I find out in the book all about these days you talked about, like Christmas, Thanksgiving, celebrating these days? I was about to ask you that, but you didn't say in the book.
Right. Give me Acts chapter 8. Acts chapter 8, it's another step. It's another step. And then what's that scripture where it talks about the Spirit of God strengthened my memory? It's in the pocket. Okay, remember that. Acts 8, you're Acts. There you go. Okay. Acts 8, verse 30.
The book of Acts, chapter 8, and verse 30. And Philip ran thither to him.
So it's a brother that was reading the Bible. Let's say you picked up the Bible the first time. Right? Read.
And heard him read the prophet Isaiah.
He was reading the book of Isaiah. Isaiah's a hard book. You gotta get some understanding of it. Read.
And say, understandest thou what thou readest?
So we would come to you and be like, you understand what you're reading, black man? You understand what you're reading? Let's see what that man says. Read.
And he said, how can I, except some man should guide me?
Some woman.
Except some man should guide me.
It says, God says, you have to go to the men of the Lord to learn the Bible. It goes right back to that congregating thing, because it says the flock of my pasture are men. You understand? So on top of, okay, you're right, I do got to change. You're going to be around men that's going to push you to change. And as you do that, read that Ezra 14:40. I think that's what it is. 2 Ezra 14:40, read.
The book of 2 Ezra, chapter 14, verse 40. And I took it and drank, and when I had drunk of it, my heart uttered understanding.
He's talking about he took the Bible and understood it. Let's see what happens when you take and understand the Bible. Read.
And wisdom grew in my breast. For my spirit.
For my what?
For my spirit.
When my spirit bear witness with this spirit, read.
Strengthen my memory.
So you can't say, I forgot. It's gonna strengthen your memory. It's gonna make you bethink yourself. When something makes you bethink yourself, it becomes muscle memory. These commandments have to be muscle memory. This ain't a fad. This ain't something that, and guess what? Your family is going to tell you that you're crazy. Your family going to tell you, oh, you be back over here smoking weed with us soon, bro. This is coming back to who you truly are.
That's right.
Wait. Yes, yes.
The book of Psalms, chapter 111 and verse 10.
Bring it out.
The fear of the Lord is the beginning of wisdom.
So as you start reading the Bible, and when you see people that got put to death for not keeping those things that you want to know about, it makes you fear what?
The fear of the Lord is the beginning of wisdom.
So yes, it's good. It's a sweet book. It's good. I'm the greatest. I'm the Israelite just because it looks like me. It becomes bitter when it tells you that God will kill you if you keep wearing short shorts. God will kill you if you keep shaving up your beard. God will kill you if you keep wearing pants. Straight up truth. I know nobody's never ever told you like that. The pastor may say we saved through grace and through faith. The grace and faith is keeping the commandments God told us.
Right. One more thing.
Let me finish the scripture. I got you. Let me finish the scripture.
The fear of the Lord is the beginning of wisdom. A good understanding have all they that do his commandments.
So when you see people doing the commandments, those are the people that you need to go listen to, because there's multiple organizations that call themselves the Israelites. We are Israelite in Christ. We are not a hate group. We keep the faith in Jesus Christ and the commandments. So when you do your search, you need to find someone that's keeping the faith in Jesus Christ and the commandments. What's your question?
I want to ask you, now they got two Israelites, right? How would I know who is who?
We need to get to the top.
The fear of the Lord is the beginning of wisdom. A good understanding have all they that do his commandments.
You may have multiple organizations. Follow the one that keeps the commandments of God. Matthew chapter 5, let your light so shine. Because the Bible says, if I'm telling you, the Bible says we're fringes. That means if I'm teaching you, I got to have what? I got to have all fringes. It might say, judge ye not, lest you be judged. I can't be a hypocrite among men. I can't say, well, you need to guide your household, and I'm not guiding mine. I can't tell you you're supposed to have one wife, and I got 18. I can't tell you you're supposed to be not getting drunk, but I get drunk. You understand what I'm saying? Read.
The book of Matthew, chapter 5 and verse 16.
Bring it
up. Let your light so shine.
What is the light? Proverbs 6:23. Hold that. You see what the light is. It says, let your light so.
The book of Proverbs, chapter 6 and verse 23.
Bring it up.
For the commandment.
The what?
And the love.
Which is the truth, which is the only way we can get the hell out of here, this captivity, read.
Is light.
Because guess what? It says gross darkness to people. This world is in darkness. The only bit of light on this whole block is these purple shirts. The only bit of light that you see is these purple shirts right now in this Bible. Why is that? Because you was blind to the fact that you needed to guide your house in a certain way. You was blind to the fact that you can't have interracial marriage. You was blind to the fact that, guess what, you're supposed to be putting some clothes on. You was blind to the fact that you didn't know what the Sabbath day. But guess what, when this book opened, the glorious light of Jesus Christ showed you what you need to do. And the kingdom is lamp and the law is light. Matthew 5.
Matthew chapter 5, verse 16. Let your light so shine before men.
Who?
Before men.
No, just when I'm in a congregation.
Before men.
So guess what? When you're also choosing, you need to have or get around people that's going to show the light among men. That means if God says, where are your fringes all the time, you wear your fringes all the time. You understand what I'm saying?
That they may see.
No, that they may think.
That they may see.
No, you only know I'm an Israelite when I say Shalom Ah.
That they may see your good works and glorify your Father which is in heaven.
So also in the choosing process, figure out what Israelites are doing the work. Who are out here on the street?
Right.
Teaching. So that your works may be seen among men. Not seen among men in a vainglorious way, but that way Jesus Christ can be glorified. Go ahead, brother. What's your next question?
I had asked him, it's like you said, a woman might go to hell with a show. Like a man.
We there is no going to hell. We're already in hell.
Right. I can't grow a beard. Then what?
Give me that with your clean. It's Leviticus 13, I think, right? 13:40? Yeah. I'm gonna get an example, 13:40. Read that. And that give me Ezra 5:1. Read.
The book of Leviticus, chapter 13 and verse 40. And the man whose hair is falling off his head.
So the man's hair that has fallen off her head. So let's say it's naturally, right? So let's say naturally, you can't grow as much as I can grow.
That's what I'm saying.
God said, I'm giving an example about someone naturally going bald. Okay? So let's say I have a gone hairline. I didn't shave it off because the law says you can't shave off your hair. But I naturally, let's see if God is okay with that, right?
And the man whose hair is falling off his head, he is bald, yet is he clean.
And is he what?
Yet is he clean.
So guess what? God in the beginning is called the author of beauty.
That's right.
God said, let us make man in our image. So what God gave you, it was perfect in his sight.
That's right.
So let's say that you grow this, because I can see your shadow. You can grow more than you showing up, shaving off now.
I know I can grow more, just that it's not thick, it scratches, go in. So I don't know, you know.
What you can do is this,
Ezra
5:1. Ezekiel 5:1. Because you shape up what you have. You know what I'm saying? But you see how this is my natural line?
Right.
I can't go in here and make a thin chin strap. But my beard can get longer than this. But for job purposes, I may have to cut it down to a certain inch. But I let them know that I cannot go into my natural life for religious purposes.
The book of Ezekiel, chapter 5 and verse 1.
Bring it out.
And thou, son of man, take me a sharp knife. Take me a barber's razor.
A what?
A barber's razor. And cause it to pass upon thine head and upon thy beard.
So he says, shape up what you got. Because you want to make sure you look good in the sight of God. Because you're going to be going to. Yes, they will have to as well. Because the Most High God set up the family structure. It's, you know, 1 Corinthians 11, and he went over, it's God, Christ, man, woman, children. But of course, there are certain laws that's made for women, according to laws that's made for men. Of course, if I'm over you, that doesn't mean you're supposed to have a beard. That law's for me. But the law for the dress is for the woman. But so yes, they will have to. How do you feel about that? Okay.
Or small bubbles. Or
give me Titus chapter 2. Titus 2. Titus 2 and, yeah, give me Titus 2 and Ephesians 5. Read.
The book of Titus.
Start verse 1.
Chapter 2 and verse 1. But speak thou the things which become sound doctrine.
What is the doctrine? The doctrine is God's laws. So that's what we're speaking. We're speaking God's laws. He says, speak unto my people sound doctrine. Sound doctrine means solid, confirmed. Read.
That the aged men be sober.
Aged men, you gotta be sober. So you can't be, just because you might have broke back in the day, and you can't play basketball no more. That don't mean that you walk up and down the street sober.
It says the aged man's supposed to be sober.
Pray.
Check. It says what?
Pray.
You're supposed to be serious. Read.
Temperate.
Able to understand and control.
Sound in faith.
Sound in
faith. What does it mean to be sound in faith? The Bible.
You figure that out. Then you stick with it.
In charity. In patience.
In what?
In patience.
Gotta be patient with your people. Read.
The aged women likewise.
Now, the same way. The aged women likewise, because if you come into the congregation and you start applying these laws, soon, the younger sisters are going to be coming to you, asking you the same questions you had.
That's right.
So it says, the aged woman, likewise, you got to have all those same traits as men.
Right.
Likewise, read.
That they be in behavior as becometh holiness.
You got to have holy behavior. Let's read some. Read.
Not false accusers.
You cannot be a gossiper. Girl, let me tell you the tea. You can't be that.
Bring it up.
You can't be false accusers.
Bring it out.
Read.
Not given to much wine.
You can't be the drunk woman in the corner. Can't be that either. Read.
Teachers of good things.
What?
Teachers of good things.
So it's not only a womanly thing for telling your daughters to wear a dress, it's a good thing. The laws of God is good. Read.
That they may teach the young women.
May teach the what?
That they may teach the young women to be sober.
To be what?
To be sober.
So you learn how to be sober first, you can teach them how to be sober. Read.
To love their husband.
Women, believe it or not, you actually have to be taught how to love your husband.
Right, bring it up.
You just don't love your husband because you said I do. Just because both of y'all have been messing around and getting back together, messing around and getting back together for so long, now both of you about to die. Now both of you about to die, and then we might as well.
That's not loving your husband.
To love their children.
You gotta be taught how to love your children too.
Bring
so
it out!
You love your children if you don't love yourself or God first.
We used to scream black power while Heron was pushed. But at the end of the day, nothing's in vain. IUIC has been given a vision. The tents of Judah has risen. Many has attempted the mission. Minor murmuring, omitting, and missing the mark. Just reading that he had the flame of fire in his eyes gave us the spark. We on Paul's mission. We out on the road, purple and gold. From Mexico, Cuba, Haiti, Ghana, Sierra Leone. 144,000 boots banging, concrete crackling. These are how our men repented at heart. The scriptures is proof. IUIC, we deliver the truth.